Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI range slider control. Using the .NET MAUI range slider, you can select a range of values by sliding a thumb along a track. In this video, I will show you how to add the range slider control to the .NET MAUI application. I will also demonstrate how to bind values, set minimum and maximum values, intervals, labels, tooltips, ticks, and dividers, and change the orientation. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a new project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and provide a project name and location. Here, I'll proceed to create the project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the project is ready. Before I move forward, let's take a quick detour to set up the environment for running our application. Here, I choose an Android emulator. For this demonstration, I will select the Pixel 5 Android emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I'll run the application and show you the default output. The application has started compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. And now the application's homepage is displayed. Next, I will show you how to incorporate a Syncfusion.NET MAUI range slider into this application. I open the NuGet package manager. Search for the Syncfusion MAUI sliders package and install it in my application. It will take a few seconds to complete the installation. Once the package is installed, I need to register the Syncfusion core handler to map the cross-platform API to the native view API. So, open the MAUI program file and add Syncfusion MAUI core hosting. Then register the handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it's necessary to register a trial license key. I can do this by opening the AppSAML CS file. Add the register license method and enter the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, you'll find a link to instructions in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main XAML page and remove the default scroll view related code. Then import the Syncfusion MAUI sliders namespace. And initialize the control by adding the SF range slider tag. I press the F5 key to run this application. See, a default range slider is rendered, and you can choose any range by dragging the thumb. To identify the range values and enhance the readability of a range slider, you can show the labels. To do that, I enable the Show Labels property. And the range slider renders with labels. By default, the minimum value of the slider is 0 and the maximum value is 1. The interval is calculated based on the screen size, minimum and maximum values. Here the interval is 0.1. If you want to customize the track range and intervals, you can use the properties minimum, maximum, and interval among others. For example, for a range of 0 to 10 with an interval of 2, just set the minimum value to 0. the maximum value to 10, and the interval to 2. The current values of the range slider can be represented by the range start and range end properties. I set the range start to 3 and range end to 7. Checking now, the track in the slider is customized based on the provided values, and the thumb is drawn corresponding to these range start and range end values. If you want to apply formats for labels, you can use the number format property. I set its value to currency format. And here, the currency format is applied to the labels. Next, let's enable the tick lines for the slider. To do that, I enable the showticks property in the control. Looking now, the major tick lines are shown in the slider track. You can also add minor ticks between major ticks. To do that, I add the minor ticks per interval property and set its value to 1. Here, the minor ticks are shown in between the major ticks. By default, the slider's highest value is shown on the right and the lowest value on the left. If you want to inverse the slider, then enable the isInversed property. Thus, the slider renders with the highest value on the left side and lower values on the right side. Apart from these options, you also have another option to indicate the values selected during interaction using a tooltip. To demo, I add the tooltip property. And include the slider tooltip. Checking now, a tooltip is shown for the selected values. Next, I will show you how to divide the sliders using shapes to represent the major interval points. To do that, I enable the show dividers property. Check now, dividers are shown for major interval points, but they look too small. So let me show you how to customize the active and inactive radius of the divider. To do that, I add a divider style property. Then, I define the slider divider style with the active radius property at 5. And inactive radius at 8. See, the radius of the divider is increased based on the provided values. Finally, I will show you how to select track values discretely. To do that, I include the step size property. And then I set its value to 2. And now, the values are selected discretely. The range slider is rendered horizontally by default. But I can also show it vertically. To do that, I include the orientation property and set its value to vertical. See, the slider renders with vertical orientation. In this video, I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add the Syncfusion MAUI range slider control with a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our .NET MAUI products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.